Hey guys, it's Sam, and today is Monday, September 7th. Happy Labor Day to those of you that celebrate Labor Day, around Labor Day weekend. You know that summer has kind of officially ended and that school is beginning. For a while, we didn't know what was going on, and we do have to go in tomorrow. For those of you that don't know what I'm talking about, I work in a New York City public school as a paraprofessional, and we are going back tomorrow. The children don't start until the 16th, and that's they start off remotely or online, and then we will start meeting in school on the 21st, and not all the students at the same time. I'm glad to be back to some sort of routine and seeing my coworkers, but I'm also very scared on the other hand, and hopefully it won't. I don't know what to think. All I know is where to report tomorrow. Other than that, I'm not sure how or what we're gonna be doing. But I thought I would vlog, since the last time I uploaded was the last week of school, I thought I would vlog this year's first week of school and see how that goes. It's gonna be quite different, and I think it's definitely going to be a huge learning curve in terms of what to do, what not to do, what works, what doesn't work. And right now, it's almost evening time. It's about 7 o'clock. I am getting ready for tomorrow. I did kind of like the personal grooming stuff. I colored my hair just black, tweezed and things like that. And then I'm getting my bag ready for tomorrow. And I got one of these things. I thought this would come in handy if I've always wanted one. So that you don't have to touch as many things, and this could even open or close a door and hold groceries and stuff like that if you don't want to. Speaking of groceries, we went to Wegmans and I forgot the 18 eggs that I got in the cart. I don't know what happened there. It was because it's one of those smaller carts, and I put it and the eggs were put in the pocket at the bottom. I should have just always double check. And the thing is, though, I had brought the cart to the guys. There were guys that were rounding up the carts, and I brought it, but I don't recall seeing the eggs there. Memory is such a funny thing. I picked out the bottom half of my clothes for tomorrow, and I ate dinner, and a lot of things just need to change because I've been eating really late at night and, you know, staying up all night and just doing summertime things, I guess, even though I didn't have that much of an eventful summer. And I gotta get some laundry downstairs. I was doing like loads of laundry the other day. I didn't want to do it tonight, but I do want to bring it up. And I think that's all I want to talk to you about for right now. Maybe the next time you'll see me is in the car tomorrow. I'm not sure. Hey, do you miss these weird ankles? Good morning. It is Tuesday, September 8th. It's just turned 6:30. I've been in the car for about 5 minutes already, just warming up and looking at the stuff I had in here because I hadn't touched it since March. So it's a little bit early. Today is like a different day. Obviously, it's the first day back at work. I probably could have left a half an hour later, but I want to stick to my schedule and just get used to leaving at this time. I will do my makeup at work just because I will have time to do it. I kind of want to get into the habit of changing that and just doing everything at home, but we'll see. Need that extra sleep of 5-10 minutes. And then I have my mask and I put on a chain. It's so much easier to wear this like that. I'm gonna get started. It's about 6:30 now. We'll see how long it takes me. GPS I think says 36 minutes, but that might have changed because I looked at it a half an hour ago. I'll see you when I get to work. I made it. It took me about 45 minutes to get here, and I didn't even find parking. I drove around for about 5 minutes, but it doesn't seem like anyone is leaving. So that's a bit concerning. But I'm gonna do my makeup and hopefully somebody will leave in the next half hour or so. exciting news. A few minutes after I made that clip about looking for parking, somebody in a van moved. So a big enough spot for me to get into the right side for alternate side parking, which is when they clean the streets and cars have to move at certain times. And a big enough spot that I didn't have to work too hard. So I'm going to finish doing my makeup now. The sun just came out. I was talking to my coworker who I didn't think was going to come in today. Her job position, it doesn't require her to be in until the kids are in, I believe. I'm not sure. Anyway, so hopefully she'll find a spot. We can hang out. We both took our COVID test the same day because we were required to take a test. And we were both negative. So with our mask on, I feel kind of safe. Don't know. But my makeup is on. I put eyeliner. That's something I might start doing this year. Last year I was, previous years I was really minimal with makeup, but I decided to do kind of a little bit more, but not too much, just basic. And I'm breaking out over here, so you know, I haven't worn makeup for the whole entire summer and I missed it. So I feel like more put together, and I've said this before, but makeup, after I put on makeup, I feel a little bit more awake, which is good. Yeah, so I'm gonna wait for her. We might hang out, not sure what we're gonna do. We have an hour before our staff meeting, so I don't know. I'll try to film as much as I can. I'm home. It is about 3:45, and I got home about a couple minutes ago. I just want to show you Ava in the sun. Ava, you okay? She ran up from the basement because she likes to hang out, I think because it's cool down there. Anyway, yeah, so it was an interesting day. I could have stayed home because the location that I work at, where I'm going to work, it wasn't inspected or something. So I just stayed in the main building, but I kind of needed a computer and I didn't have one. All the meetings were remote because some teachers and paras are remote, but I feel like I could have stayed home then. And I'm wearing this, I look different from this morning because we were supposed to wear red for Ed. We took a group picture with everybody wearing red. I just decided to put it on under this shirt, and I need to decompress a little bit, and then maybe I'll come back and tell you what other things I did today. Okay, I took some time to decompress. For me, that involves coming inside, washing my hands, obviously, checking the mail, clearing out my work bag. What else? Bringing things to my office. I even started to pick out things for tomorrow, like my mask. I still have to pick out my outfit. And I like to do those little things before tonight or tomorrow, just so that I don't have to think about it anymore. And I'm about to start making dinner. It's a little bit early to be making dinner. It's about not even 4:30 yet, but I could tell in an hour or two I'm gonna be exhausted, so I'm gonna start that now. Okay, here is dinner. So I made mashed sweet potato, chicken cutlets that were breaded in flour, onion powder, and garlic powder. I should have put some lemon juice on it after, but I forgot. And then there is asparagus and a little bit of zucchini that I had pan fried. So that's tonight's dinner, and it's about 5:15 now. I am sitting in my office. I got my feet up. I'm gonna get up to get my grandmother's dinner ready. She eats around 6 o'clock. I might eat soon too, just because my energy is really plummeting here. I picked out my outfit for tomorrow. I even took out stuff out of the freezer for tomorrow's dinner. I'm making turkey stroganoff, which is nice not to have to, like, when I come home to think about what I'm gonna be making. And while I was here, I thought I would menu plan. Not with you guys, but like while I was in this room, I was thinking to myself, I should menu plan. I used to do it a lot. Well, I used to do it every week or every 2 weeks, make a menu, and it just, grocery shopping, it made it easier and just put my mind at ease. And I think I'm going to start doing that again because since lockdown, a lot of things I haven't done, but I'm going to do that right after I get up. So let me get up now. Good morning. Today is Wednesday, September 9th, and I got even less sleep than I did yesterday, which was almost none. So I had called or texted my coworker this morning because she also lives in Staten Island, and I'm able to drive to her house, but I wouldn't feel safe driving over the bridge or anything like that and doing the Brooklyn traffic. So she graciously is letting me ride in with her, and I feel bad because I'm probably putting her in an awkward situation. And we both tested negative for COVID. We took the test on the same day, so I'm really grateful, and I think I'm gonna buy her lunch on Friday because it's really nice to do. And hopefully it won't be that bad of a day. I think there's lots to do in the classroom, so that'll keep me busy. My coworker got me a chocolate croissant, which is so sweet of her, the one that drove me here. And I am just cleaning up stuff, the things that I left in March. So mugs, and I brought stuff from home to put it to my cubby. And I'm gonna start doing some classroom setup, or actually I'd be taking stuff down because we had left here in March. And although my teacher had come back, a couple of times, she couldn't do everything by herself. So I'm going to start doing some stuff because I'm here so early. We don't really have to be here until 8:39, and it's just turned 8 now. It's lunchtime. It's about 12:15. This might look familiar. It's yesterday's dinner. I didn't eat that much of it, so I brought leftovers for lunch today. And there's my water. And just trying to do as much as we can, although we can't do much. Well, I should talk. Oh, and I'm by myself here again. We don't have a lot of things that we need to move forward, so we're doing odds and ends in the classroom for right now. Hopefully we can do more stuff when we get the information that we need. Hey, I am home. It's around 4 p.m. I've been home for about 20 minutes now, resting. I've been trying to film this clip even though I'm saying a bunch of nonsense. My coworker drove me to my car, which was parked near her home, and then I took my car to the mechanic. I'm not sure how long it's going to be there. I'm hoping I'll hear from them today about how long it might take. I have to get my inspection. I have to get sorry, I'm just I love peeking out the window. Inspection, oil change, want them to check the engine light and the brakes. And I wouldn't be as concerned if I didn't commute, but since I commute, I really get nervous about the thought, or anxiety over the thought of getting stuck on either the Verrazano, or stall on the Verrazano, or the Gowanus, or the BQE. So I don't need that added stress. So I'm hoping that it can get fixed and fixed by tomorrow. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do in terms of work. I could go with my coworker again, but I don't know how comfortable she is with that, and I know she doesn't want to wear her mask while she's driving me. So I'll have to think about that. And I was thinking about I should have taken a picture of me in the morning, like after I get ready and have my makeup on all fresh, and then at the end of the day. Today I didn't put on as much makeup as yesterday, and my face here, it's not maskne or mask acne. This I feel like is from stress, lack of sleep, and lack of water. And I'm gonna try to be better about my sleep hygiene. That's one of those things I was looking up this morning while I was awake at like 5 a.m. was sleep hygiene. And the worst thing that I do is use my phone up until I decide it's time to go to sleep. And I know that's terrible for you. So I'm going to try to change a few things. That is probably going to be the hardest for me. I am going to I'm going to make dinner and then can't go to sleep. It's too early to go to sleep. I'm hoping that I will hear from the mechanic about what's going on. Oh, I took a lift from the mechanic to my house, which is driving. It's 5 minutes away, so it's not very far, and it's, I believe it's like a 20-ish minute walk home, but I had two bags with me. It's humid, I'm tired, so I spent the $10 and I took the lift. If it was a little bit cooler day and I wasn't so tired, I would have walked it because I have done it before. It's not a bad walk. So I will talk to you guys later. And I just finished making dinner. It is 5:12 p.m. There's the egg noodles. I like the extra wide. And then here is the turkey slash. Oh, a phone number is calling me, but I don't know who that is, so I will not pick it up. I've been making it recently with pork and ground turkey. Actually, I just lied to you. Sometimes I make it with ground turkey and ground pork. This time I made it with ground beef and ground pork, and you put in mushrooms, onions, garlic, and then cream of mushroom soup. And then at the last bit, what do you call that? Sour cream. And then I put on top parsley. So that's dinner. I also made a salad. I feel like this needs a veggie right here. And that salad is in the fridge. It is arugula, avocado, tomatoes, ham, and red onion. And put out a couple of choices of dressing. Yeah, so dinner's already made. I swear I don't live on this couch, but it's easiest to film here, and that's why I'm here again. Not that I have to point this out, but this here, oh my goodness, it will not go away. It's one of those like painful cystic pimples. These two were kind of similar to this, but they went away about a week. This one is going on, it's gonna be its third week soon, and I feel like it's not getting better, even though I clean my face. I try not to touch it. So it looks like it's healing, but then underneath there's more. It's super frustrating. Also, I was downstairs in the basement cleaning, doing a load of laundry, which consisted of the cloth napkins that we switched to, or we not that we had to, but there's we like a specific type of napkins, and Costco doesn't sell them or aren't selling them right now, so we just decided to use the cloth ones, and I love the change. I think it's more absorbent. You can reuse it, and I feel better about doing that. While I was down there, though, the mechanic called and basically told me that I need a new car. I'm not surprised by the news, but I wasn't expecting it. I am searching for a new car. I want a smaller SUV. The one that I really would like to get is the Jeep Compass. But let me know what recommendations you have. I don't want a huge SUV just because I need to. Sometimes I will need to take the car to Brooklyn. I was hoping to have a smaller SUV and my Volkswagen, but the Volkswagen, he said that it's not gonna last. It will be drivable after he fixes it, but it's maybe 6 months, which gives me enough time to find a car. It used to be my mom's car, and she loved the Volkswagen Bug. I just can't part with it right now, but I do have to look for a new car. I don't want to be stuck somewhere. Like, I will drive it. I don't know if I'm going to drive it for 6 months. I don't want to go reach near the 6 month point and still be driving it and get stuck somewhere. And the funny thing is, Steve's car is also messed up and he won't pass his inspection in November, I believe, is when he has to get his inspection done. So he needs to get a car before then. We both have to get a car at the same time. I think that's hilarious. Or, I mean, I still have a little bit more time. Now, what did he say was wrong with it? Well, there's a lot of words that he used. The price was what I thought it was going to be. I think it's going to be about $800. I don't think it's going to be much less than that. If anything, it'll be more. I need 2 new tires or I won't pass inspection. They changed the oil, but when they looked underneath, it was a mess. They need parts from Volkswagen. They need other things. He mentioned stuff that I just cannot repeat to you. Not because of privacy. I don't know what he said. I kind of wish they would talk to you like... He used words that I understood, but then he also used like things that I... Like whatever part he was talking about, I didn't understand what he was saying. The check underline he could fix. He said it's something... I don't know why that's on, but he said that it had to do with something. And I wish I could record these things because I don't know what he's talking about. But I'm not gonna get a car tomorrow, so I need the car to be fixed. I will drive it, but again, I will look for a new car. And any recommendations, please put them down below. Good morning. Today is Thursday, September 10th. As you can tell, I'm working from home today. My car, I just didn't know when it was going to be ready, and I didn't want to put out my coworker again. She had to wear the mask the entire time. I mean, we both wore our masks the entire time that she drove us in and into work and then back home, and I just was like, I don't want to put her through that 2 days in a row. So I am working for remote just for today. I'll be back tomorrow. I'm really hoping. They said that my car was able to be fixed, but there was like some part of him that was like, I'm gonna try to do my best. So keep your fingers crossed. But yeah, I am sitting in front of my computer and just listening to important updates. Okay, so most of my major meetings are over with today. Not sure if the pre-K team is gonna meet. I'll try to make that. Right now I'm having, I guess, brunch, but it's gonna be instant noodles. It's a stir fry dough, though, so it doesn't stay. There's no broth or anything if you don't want it to have, but it's supposed to be stir fried after you cook the noodles. And possibly a sandwich, depending on how hungry I am. I'm still in my PJs. I'm gonna change only if I go out to get my car. Haven't heard anything yet. It's 11 o'clock right now. So I got my car fixed. I picked it up at 3:30. It's 4 now. I am actually going to get a haircut. I'm kind of nervous to go in there, but I have my mask on. They're going to have their mask on. I have my hand sanitizer and hopefully it'll go okay. I'm gonna probably get it really short, but we'll see how it comes out. I'll show you when I come back. I sanitized my hands. My haircut is done. I personally like it a little less volume. I know that's the opposite of what a lot of people like, but for me, I like it more like sleek and down. And I don't like it curved in, but overall, I really like the cut. I just needed a haircut. At the beginning of the lockdown, I had my family cut my hair just because I think I just needed to focus on something else. It's like the same thing when you rearrange your room. You want to feel something different. So that's what I did, but it was not a great cut. Obviously, they're not hair professionals. But yeah, I really like it, and I'm happy. It's gonna probably annoy me in a few days that I can't tie my hair back, but there's enough hair that I can like pull it out of my face. So yeah, this is my new haircut. Good morning. It is Thursday, September 11th, and I just got it to work. It is 10 to, nope, maybe 15 to 8 a.m., and I don't think I need to be inside until 8:39, but I'm going to go in after I finish doing my makeup or start doing my makeup. My coworker is so funny. She just came out here and was like just chit-chatting and stuff, and I am giving her a ride home today. She texted me kind of late last night, I feel like, for a weekday, and they know that I have sleep issues, but I was like, sure, no problem. She was so kind to me the other days, and I don't mind taking her home because it's not out of the way. I have to go that way to go home anyway, so I didn't even start putting on my makeup. I'm gonna do that now and then go inside. Okay, here's my outfit of the day. Here's my mask. It's from Target. Just wearing a black top from Macy's and then blue jeans. I forgot where they're from. And then I have my Vans on. Van high tops on. It is a little bit after 12. I keep on having to do this because our custodian keeps on coming in and out. Like, I don't know why. Just, confusing. Anyway, it's my coworker just ordered sushi. Hopefully, she's gonna go get it. I'm starving, so hopefully it'll be here soon. I am wearing a different shirt from this morning because my teacher was wearing her tie-dye shirt. It's our class t-shirt from last year, and I had mine here, so I was like, why don't I wear it? So that kind of like, oh, they're definitely from the same class. Because we're gonna send out a picture of us to the families with our mask on and without, so they kind of get a heads up of what we look like. And I am just trying to do as much as possible. We actually don't have a official class list, so there's only so much we can do. So I'm just cleaning everything and organizing. I'll show you. So this is what I am doing. They're all in here, and I'm just trying to clean as much as I can.
Well, you need to get found now.
I thought yesterday was Wednesday.
Oh, no.
Hey, it's 4 p.m. I am home. I just wanted to check in with you. I think I'll film an ending to the vlog sometime later. There was a lot of traffic coming home Friday, typical. I thought it would be less because parents and children aren't even on the road yet. So it was just kind of frustrating, especially on a Friday. And I dropped off my coworker because she's on the way, and she asked me for a ride home, no problem. And I think that's it for right now. I know every time you see me, my hair is in a different shape or different position. Hey, so today is actually Sunday evening, and I forgot to close out the vlog that I did for the first week back to work. And I am optimistic, but still very nervous about when the kids start coming into school and how that's gonna look like. But I'm just gonna try to stay positive, and I could only do what I can do, and hopefully it will be okay. I will just, have to be very diligent about wearing my mask and washing hands, and so I hope you guys are all doing well. Good luck to you all. If you have children or you are working in a school or whatever it is you're doing, stay safe, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.